the Tape is brought to you by Performance Inspired, the all-natural, high-performance line of sports nutrition, trusted by athletes and health enthusiasts. Visit pi-nutrition.com. Anthony Pettis, 30 years old. Jim Miller, the southpaw, is 33. Pettis, 2 inches taller. Anthony Pettis will have a reach advantage of an inch and a half. All right, now for the official introductions, back inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist, fully professional record, 28 wins, 9 losses, 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Sparta, New Jersey, Jim A.10 Miller. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record, 19 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 156 pounds. Fighting out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, presenting the former WEC lightweight champion and the former UFC lightweight champion, Anthony Showtime Pettis! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, your referee for this lightweight fight between the veteran staples, Jim Miller and Anthony Pettis. Speaking of veteran staples, Ariadne Celeste with us.
Ready, let's do it.
And we are ready to go. This fight clock is brought to you by Budweiser. This Bud's for you. Jim Miller, the southpaw's in blue. Anthony Showtime, Pettis in black.
Well, Pettis will switch it up, southpaw to orthodox. And you see Miller opening up with that low leg kick, which he used to great success in the Dustin Poirier fight. Had Dustin really hurt with that low kick, and he goes to it over and over again here.
And he doesn't just go to the thigh. He goes down by your calf and just kills the leg. And I like Miller attacking Anthony Pettis early, because you mentioned, Joe, during the walkout, there's no metric or stat for confidence. And if you can get aggressive and get some success with Anthony Pettis early, break his confidence, man, he's just not the same guy.
Yeah, you got to think about where his head's at. Losing to Rafael Dos Anjos, losing to Eddie Alvarez, getting beaten down by Max Holloway in his last fight. I mean, he's had some rough moments in his career, but he's still only 30 years old, and he's still uber-talented. It's just a matter of where's his mind at, how's his training camp, and can he handle the war? Inside leg kick again.
Man.
And that will take away your mobility.
And Anthony always likes to stand towards the open side of his opponent. So if he's facing a southpaw, he likes the orthodox stance, the body's open to his body kick. Like standing southpaw against right-handed fighters. So let's see if he switches his stance, if he eats another one of those low kicks.
Pettis with a lot to prove here tonight, but really every fight of his WEC and UFC tenure has been a big one. No different here. Pettis just misses on the right-hand count.
Pettis doing a nice job of maintaining his range right now. He told me this week that's his key to winning the fight. He gets his range, that puts all of his weapons where they need to be. And this kid's a sniper, man. He sees an opening. There's no telegraph in the strike.
Jim Miller again with that low kick. He just keeps attacking that calf. Ooh, good kick to the body by Pettis.
I like these feints from Jim Miller. That'll draw out some of these kicks, some of the techniques from Anthony Pettis, and allow Jim Miller to get inside and land his own combinations and potentially some takedowns, which he would also like to do in this fight, put Anthony Pettis on his back.
Stiff right hand lands there for Pettis. Less than 3 minutes here to go, round one. Miller once again finding a home for that left kick.
Beautiful kick by Pettis.
Really nice counter.
Flying knee. He hurt him.
Miller covering up, yet still returning fire.
Anyway, as he was covering up, though, Pettis was altering. He'd thrown the right hook instead of the straight. Landed it twice.
And he's mixing it up, going to the body as well.
Back against the fence is not where Jim Miller wants to be. The fights he wins, he's pressing forward. He does a much better job when he can back his opponent up.
That straight right hand is beautiful by Pettis. When he's not telegraphing it at all. He's just dropping it in there.
And Dan Miller to our right, Jim Miller's brother, looks concerned.
Boy, and Pettis getting right out of range. He's nailing him and then watching Jim Miller whiff.
Ooh. On the arms. And goes straight down the middle with that front kick as well. He's really mixing it up. Showing that creativity that really highlighted his early career.
And again, this isn't something, these aren't techniques that left him. That's just a thing of beauty right there.
Spinning back fist.
You wonder where his confidence was. It's obviously high right now.
Miller somehow able to eat that spinning back fist without too much issue. You see some of the redness in that body area for Jim Miller.
Oh, beautiful switch kick. And that's that Taekwondo background. He's got such a great mix of traditional martial arts techniques plus Muay Thai and again, his underrated submission game.
And his submissions are quick, too. I mean, it's lightning fast how quick he can change his hips. Look at him inviting Miller to kick his lead leg. He wants him to do it.
Beautiful right hand counter lands for Anthony Pettis. We go under 30 seconds now to go round one.
Wait, no takedown attempts from Miller yet. Not even just trying to look for a single to get his back off the fence. Nice shot to the body there, though.
And landed the right hand over the top as well.
Good kick to the body by Miller as well. Oh, head kick.
Man.
He caught that one on the chin. He might have got wobbled.
Outstanding first round as expected. Tonight's Corner King is brought to you by Performance Inspired, the all-natural high-performance line of sports nutrition, trusted by athletes and health enthusiasts. Visit pi-nutrition.com.
Lean back, because he's trying to come over. Yes, sir. You're looking great. Okay? Little level change fakes. Coach said he's going to be shooting. So be ready for that knee.
Overhand shot. Those are his main focus right there.
So early on, Miller was having success with this inside leg kick. Over and over again, he landed it. But Pettis seemed to find his range, get his confidence and his timing, and towards the second half of the round, he really started to shine.
And he was so accurate as well. I mean, he's finding a home for that right hand almost every single time he throws it. Look at him step through here with the fake of the kick, and bam! Caught him flush to the left side of his face. Miller is tough as they come, but man, he can't eat too many of those.
Yeah, Miller with good low kicks early, but all Pettis towards the second half of the round. And Pettis has got a feeling about him now. Like he's energized, he's confident, and he's got momentum on his side now.
Very important for Jim Miller to do something to break that rhythm now. Nice left hand there. Pettis expecting a shot as his corners warn him. Expect Jim Miller to shoot and try and wrestle him off. Let's see if Jim does.
Well, that has been where Pettis has had problems in the past. The only guy who really beat him standing up was Edson Barboza. Other than the Max Holloway
Max
fight,
Holloway,
which he was
yep.
kind of really depleted. He had no business being at 145
no.
pounds.
But every other fight we've seen Anthony Pettis lose, people have wrestled him. They've put him on the fence. They've controlled him. They've neutralized him.
And that was what Gilbert Melendez tried unsuccessfully, and he got caught in a guillotine. Now, submitting Gilbert Melendez is just a huge
incredible.
Feather in Anthony Pettis' cap and shows you how talented he is. Oh, he went high.
Oh, huge opportunity here for Jim Miller.
Just as his corner called for him to wrestle, there is that
this.
Jim Miller
Ooh.
Corner.
For the triangle.
If it's not instant,
oh,
wow.
He doesn't have it. Someone's bleeding.
I believe it's Jim Miller. He's bleeding badly. Able to squirm out.
Helping him get out of the triangle
right.
attempts.
I wonder where the cut is. It's hard for us to tell here with Miller's
come,
face down.
He's going to come right back for the triangle there. Miller smartly postures up immediate.
We're being told it was a head kick that opened up the cut. Yeah, it was a right high kick.
And that's the same kick Miller caught to actually get this takedown. That's how tough Jim is.
Miller just landed a good elbow from the top. He may have cut Pettis.
But all the bleeding is actually making it harder for Anthony Pettis to get any grip and mount any offense with his guard. It's helping Jim Miller, who needed this top control time.
3 minutes here to go in round two. It wouldn't be a Jim Miller fight unless both bodies were covered in blood. All Miller just missed on that, or so it appeared.
Again, what Pettis is showing off of his back is not just good defensive ability, but he's threatening. You see, again, every time Miller tries to get out of there, Pettis is threatening. But now Miller's got his back. Now, here's what's interesting. The same blood that was a problem when Pettis is trying to set things up actually aids Miller if he's trying to get that arm under the neck. Because all that slipperiness is good if you can sink in a rear naked choke.
I'll tell you what, I've grappled with Jim Miller before. He is deceptively strong on the ground for his weight.
Look at this, look at this. Beautiful transition there, wow. And Pettis is off the back.
And Pettis is so smooth on the ground himself. Really nicely done.
And Pettis,
elbows.
Yep, no interest in letting Miller back to his feet.
Some hard, short elbows by Pettis. And look for Pettis to target that cut as well. And you hear Duke Rufus calling out for shoulder pressure. They want him to pass. And they don't want him to get swept. It's going to be very difficult for Miller to control Pettis' body here because of all the sweat, all the blood.
Here's Miller's best opportunity to kick away and get up, and he needs to take advantage of it. Pettis nicely keeping the pressure on him. But Miller's having a hard time seeing right now. He's doing a good job neutralizing some of the ground and pound, but no threat whatsoever to dig for an underhook here, get to a hip, and try and get back to his feet.
Hard elbow there by Pettis. And he's passing, moves to side control.
Looking to mount now.
Less than a minute now to go here in round two. Pettis continuing to apply pressure here on the ground. And yeah, the vision of Jim Miller, a real factor here.
He's looking for the Americana on the left arm of Jim Miller.
Staying really busy on top, which really, it gives Miller no opportunity to try and scramble out of this position. He's constantly on the defense, whether it's ground and pound or a sub attempt or
Miller's
a transition.
Giving us some back. Miller trying, he got a little impatient there. And he almost tried to pop up out of that and expose his neck. He's got to do this technically. Can't sleep on the grappling. And Miller back up to his feet. What a fight. And beautiful
wow.
Trip.
Wow. Something we don't see that often from Anthony Pettis. Him looking for takedowns really highlights the work he's done with his wrestling coach, Israel Martinez.
Outstanding final 2 minutes of the round for Anthony Showtime Pettis. Mutual show of respect there. Tonight's quarter cam is brought to you by Performance Inspired, the all-natural high-performance line of sports nutrition trusted by athletes and health enthusiasts. Visit pi-nutrition.com. They will work on that cut of Jim Miller.
We got a crowd. He's only looking for his armbar. He can only get that if he moves his hips up. It's awesome. Let me just take a look. On the bottom, we got to get to our full, or we got to get the shot. What?
Get a hold of
him. I know, I understand. Relax. Relax. We know we can get a takedown. We know we can finish it. Okay? Yeah, if you get desperate, you have the leg option.
Come on, suck it up. 5 minutes, buddy.
And here is the right high kick.
Bam, and Miller, tough enough, catches it, eats it, catches it, sweeps the leg, gets on top. But that's what opened up that massive cut. And then here's Pettis really showing the diversity, his ground and pound, excellent ability to maintain top position. And then takedown of his own as he reaps the leg out from under him, takes him down. Momentum all on the side of Anthony Pettis right now.
Brian, what'd you think about Jim Miller's corner thinking that they should take this fight to the ground?
I mean, you know, I guess they're thinking on the feet, he's just not having any success with Anthony. So they want him to go on top where they believe he could finish him. We haven't seen him execute a takedown yet, outside of catching the kick.
And I'm surprised they don't have him go back to that low leg kick that he was having such success with. I mean, he just abandoned that. There it is. Beautiful. I mean, it's such a painful kick.
Oh, it's awful. And again, if Anthony can't put weight on that lead leg, it really limits a lot of his offense and may cause him to have to switch stances.
There it is again. And that's one of those kicks where just one or two of them can drastically reduce your ability to move.
And that part of the body is just, it's not used to getting hit at all. So it's very new for fighters to eat that. We saw it in one of the fights last night where a fighter's calf was hurt very bad.
Well, next Sunday, it's an FS1 UFC Fight Night welterweight main event. Gunnar Nelson, Santiago Ponzinibbio. Special start time Sunday, July 16th, 3 p.m. Eastern, noon Pacific.
Oh, there he is again. FS1. He landed it again.
And I like that he's going back to it. I mean, it's been his best offense by far. But what he can't afford to do is sit at this range. This is Anthony Pettis' range where he, despite those leg kicks, he's still landing more frequently. Miller has got to press the action and pressure. Whether it's takedowns or combinations, I don't care what they are. But if Miller wants any chance of winning this fight, he needs to start moving forward.
And he went up the middle with a front kick there.
Yep.
Pettis is just so dynamic with his kicking ability.
And there's just, you can't see it coming. There's no telegraph.
Under 3 minutes here to go in this third and final round. That is now circling the other way towards that power left of Jim Miller. Well, not sure it ever left, but the confidence is there for Anthony Showtime Pettis tonight. Let's listen in to Duke Rufus and company.
Give me your fake takedown. Bubble change. Here we go.
Too fast.
Another excellent leg kick there by Miller. Pettis light on the feet here. Not showing any ill effects from those kicks.
No, and he's moving those feet so Jim Miller can't hit him with those low kicks anymore. It's when he's standing stationary that Miller sets those up.
Yeah, Miller's getting him in the transition like right here.
Yep.
Under 2 minutes now to go. Good shot from Miller, but Pettis stays upright.
Wow. Excellent job. Quickly digging for underhooks. Good balance from Anthony Pettis there to defend that.
Izzy style wrestling on display.
A lot of damage inflicted by Pettis on that left leg of Jim Miller. One underhook, now two.
And this clinch portion of Anthony Pettis' game, this is typically viewed as a weakness by most of his opposition. Doing a nice job controlling Jim Miller up against the fence now.
Good elbow.
Interesting, too, because Pettis' corner was calling for that technique. They wanted him to throw the elbow.
Miller trying to get some air into those lungs. Pettis continues to apply pressure. 45 seconds to go now. Crowd getting behind these athletes here in the waning seconds of this one. Little groin strike there. Pettis says, let's fight on.
Oh! Wow.
Outstanding fight.
Great fight.
Between Anthony Showtime Pettis and Jim Miller, both guys pulling out all the stops down the stretch.
And that looked to me like Anthony Pettis returning to form.
He looked fantastic. Jim Miller is no easy out whatsoever, and Pettis looked fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, he's the winningest lightweight in UFC history is Jim Miller. Let's get to the fight replay brought to you by Budweiser. This Bud's for you.
Well, we're used to seeing some real fancy striking from Pettis. He had a lot of low kicks, but he responded well with some counters there. Right hand and same side kick, flying knee, and this would hurt Jim Miller in round one. And really, that was a turning point after he ate a lot of those low kicks. Anthony Pettis got it done very well on the feet here. Kicks him in the head back, opened up the huge cut. Front kick to the face. These are things we're used to seeing from Anthony Pettis, but you're not seeing these highlights. The clinch game, some of the wrestling here. Zanchai kick comes behind, hits him in the back. Beautiful creativity, excellent accuracy. really controlled the range and the distance so well by Anthony Pettis, but I was most impressed with his wrestling and controlling the clinch.
These fight statistics coming up here brought to you by Performance Inspired, the all-natural high-performance line of sports nutrition trusted by athletes and health enthusiasts. Visit pi-nutrition.com. So you see some of the numbers there for Anthony Pettis and Jim Miller. Head strikes all Showtime. Pettis, top position, pretty even. Leg strikes to Jim Miller. But unofficially, Anthony Pettis landing nearly 70% of his total strike attempts here tonight. Jim Miller under 50%. The official decision now brought to you by Metro PCS, who brings you closer than ever to the UFC on a fast nationwide 4G LTE network. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score this contest 30-27 for the winner by unanimous decision, Anthony Showtime Pettis!
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.